David Guetta by Becky Hill and David Guetta. And I'll be talking about two films today: Deepwater Horizon and Patriots Day. So I decided to do a duo with this review because they star the same guy, Mark Wahlberg, and they're directed by the same director, Peter Berg. And both these films talk about events in U.S. history that have shaped a culture. So from an American perspective, like, these are kind of cool films to watch to kind of understand and even see in sort of, yeah, like, live, in a live format, how these events came up and their repercussions. So the first one, Deepwater Horizon, it's about how on April 20th, 2010, the Deepwater Horizon drilling rig exploded in the Gulf of Mexico, ignited a massive fireball that killed several crew members. Chief electronics technician Mike Williams and his colleagues found themselves fighting for survival as the heat and the flames became stifling and overwhelming. Banding together, the co-workers must use their wits to make it out alive amid all the chaos. Yeah, some weird verb use I did in that. Started, like, talking in the past since then. But yeah, it's a good film, basically. To get back to the point. Four-fifths of the critics and audience scores for RottenTomatoes.com gave a pretty good review. The critic consensus is Deepwater Horizon makes effective use of its titular man-made disaster to deliver an uncommonly serious yet still suitably gripping action thriller. Yeah, so to expand on that, it's very, like, realistic, and you see why this Deepwater Horizon rig blew up, and having seen the workers on the rig, like, deal with it, and it gets crazy and intense, like, and it shows how dangerous the work could potentially be. Okay, moving on to Patriots Day. So in this film, tragedy strikes on April 15, 2013, when two bombs explode during the Boston Marathon. In the aftermath of the attack, Sergeant Tommy Saunders and FBI agent Desloriers and Commissioner Ed Davis join courageous survivors, first responders, and other investigators in a race against time to hunt down the suspects and bring them to justice. So yeah, this film follows the suspects who actually did do the bombing before the bombing, and most of it's a manhunt, but you do actually see the actual marathon bombing too. And of course, the main lead is Mark Wahlberg, the guy who is significant in this manhunt. So yeah, this film kind of has a really American patriotic feel to it. I'm not really sure why it's called Patriots Day. Maybe it's a holiday I'm not familiar with. I don't know. Or maybe, you know, I don't want to sound ignorant of American culture, but disregarding the name, it's a good film. Yeah, four-fifths of critics and audiences like it. The critic consensus is Patriots Day offers a stirring and solidly crafted tribute to the heroes of a real-life American tragedy without straying into exploitative action thriller territory. Yeah, so there's nothing is, like, kind of over-dramatic or overblown in this film. Like, it's pretty straightforward, same way Deepwater Horizon is. And that's why I like the director, Peter Berg, and the way he directed these two films. This film in particular has more of, like, a civic tribute to the city of Boston. I'm not from Boston, but Boston is a pretty significant city culturally in the U.S. and also in the film industry, where a lot of famous actors are from, such as, I believe, Mark Wahlberg. So this must have been he must have enjoyed filming this. I don't know, because he's from Boston, you know, and it's nice to have the story that shaped his hometown, you know, brought to life. I'm assuming this, I don't know, but I think he is a Bostonian, if that's what you call people from Boston. I'm not sure. Anyway, these are two great, just even solid action thriller films, and also just to learn about American disasters and how people get through them and how people grow from them, learn from them, you know, whatnot. So that's it for that. I'm done reviewing those films. Yeah, Deepwater Horizon, Patriots Day, I recommend. Listening to The Motto now by Tiesto and Ava Max, not sure how to pronounce her name. Take it easy, y'all. Until then, peace.